So coming here today, we learnt off the barman that it's a climate change, algae, you know, going to change the world a little bit with the CO2 to oxygen, makes us even happier. So we're happy to have a beer, have a chat, change the world.
This Australian brewery is pairing beer with algae to cut its carbon emissions.
I think one thing that we do get asked a lot is there algae in the beer? And no, there's not algae in the beer. The beer is unchanged. The algae is just part of the production process. It never touches the beer. This is not green beer.
Young Henry's Brewery in Australia is reducing its carbon footprint by keeping two bioreactors teeming with microalgae in the back. The team captures the carbon that is emitted while the beer is fermenting and feed it to the algae, which transform the carbon dioxide into oxygen.
As an urban carbon sequestration and oxygen producing solution, it's mind-blowing. We could knock down our whole site and plant trees, and those trees, it would take years before they did the same amount of carbon sequestration and oxygen creation as those two bioreactors, that we can start them up within a week and they're creating oxygen.
The team set up the bioreactors with help from the University of Technology, Sydney, UTS.
So this relatively rudimentary setup is a hose connected to one of our fermenting beer tanks. The CO2 off the top of that beer basically runs through the hose, is captured in this balloon. This balloon then feeds CO2 into this compressor where it's compressed. It's blended there with oxygen at a specific dosage rate and is actually dosed through these two bioreactors full of microalgae a couple of times a day. Basically, the CO2 is then ingested by microalgae that uses it to photosynthesize. That creates more algae, releases oxygen, and the world is a better place for it.
The Young Henry's team and UTS have teamed up with Meat and Livestock Australia to see if the algae can offset any of the livestock industry's emissions. The brewery's leftover grain is sent to be used as cattle feed, and early research indicates that mixing in microalgae could reduce methane emissions from cows by up to 20%.
So the future, as I see, is going to be a whole range of algae producers that are going to take somebody's waste, whether it's CO2, nutrients from a sewage treatment plant or from food waste, taking those waste products and making a new product, and this is going to create circular economies. Instead of us digging something up, making a product and then throwing it away, we circularise it and we're going to actually use our carbon effectively. And I think that's going to be the future, where industries want to use recycled carbon, not fossil carbon.